Hello there, Scorpio, and welcome back for another tarot reading. Today, Scorpio, I have a treat for you. Actually, I was thinking about Scorpio. I was channeling your energy, Scorpio, and I just felt the need to question why your readings, and I'm not saying, they're always negative, but in order to pull new love, we're going to call this the New Love Alert little series here. But I'm going to start with you, Scorpio. So what I decided to do was pull from my Romance Angel Oracle deck and my Love Oracle deck. I'll pull four Romance Angel Oracle cards, and I'm going to clarify all four of those cards with the Love Oracle cards here. But here's the thing, Scorpio. I was thinking that, Scorpio. Now, look, this is a general. It may or may not resonate with you. It may or may not fit, but it's up to you whether or not you receive this energy or not, okay? So if you're looking for new energy, new romance, then in these oracle cards, the Romance and the Love Oracle, and this is how Brown Eyes is thinking about it. This is what I'm doing this time. And you're pulling new energy. You wanted to meet someone new that you don't have a history with. Then it would make sense to take out the old cards that's reminiscent to past relationships, because they're all sad and betrayal types of energy cards. So that's the cards that we pull when you're further on down in the connection with someone. But if you're looking for a new love interest, then you only keep the cards, I feel, pertaining to new. So, if you haven't did a history, you haven't really put any work with this person, then this person can't be in betrayal, can't be three-party. We ain't trying to find all that out, Scorpio. We just looking for the new love, the new romance energy, okay? Without any interruptions, any interferences, because we don't want the old to blend in with the new. You get me, Scorpio? We're only interested in new love, new romance, and we don't want to take the chance to pull another card that's pertaining to something from your past when that's not what the direction you're going. You're trying to move forward. So we're only getting move forward romance and love oracle cards just for new love, okay? Like in for just like general readings, or just like your person's readings, then I'll put them all back in. But pertaining to new love, this is how I'm gonna do them. So you have four of each cards. You have a total of eight cards here. Like I say, you have four romance and four love. And I'm using the Love Oracle decks to clarify the Romance Angel Oracle decks. Thank you so much, Scorpio. Of course, if you're new to my channel and my energy resonates with you, please like, share, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and leave me a comment and take this spiritual journey with Brown Eyes here. Also, Scorpio, I'm still offering the 20 minutes for $20 personal readings if you're interested. Check out my email in the description box below. So, Scorpio, now remember, this the new love. It can't help but to be good. You feel me? This is new love. This is new romance. So it can't help but to be good, because we took out all the old shit. Ain't no residue of nothing bad. No trust issues. None of that. You feel me? All right, dog. Don't say nothing, Scorpio. So Scorpio, the first card, it says, getting to know each other. As you reveal your innermost selves to each other, your bond deepens. So see, Scorpio, we know that we're extremely emotional beings by nature, because we're Scorpios, we're water energy. Yeah, y'all, FYI, I am sipping on something. So you might see me in the zone, but we know Scorpios are very emotional. We're water, so we're good. We like to talk. We like the intimate times. We like the one-on-one time. We like to connect emotionally as well as spiritually with our partner here. So Scorpio, this is someone new who is going to be so like-minded, so in tune with your needs and who you are as a Scorpio, that they're going to be so much alike. I mean, you guys are going to have deep conversation. You ain't going to have to figure out anything about this person, Scorpio, because they're going to tell you, and you're going to feel comfortable around this person, Scorpio. So you're going to just be blabbing your mouth. It's something about this person's energy is going to make you feel very, very comfortable with them, Scorpio. Because, you're getting to know someone. You know, we always know it's always beautiful in the beginning. So that's why I said, let's just pull the new love energy here. We don't have to, what it says, more than one way to skin a monkey, or something like that, okay? So we skinning this monkey, Scorpio, okay? So this is someone who you're really going to get to know. You're going to reveal yourself. They're going to reveal themselves. They're going to talk to you. They're going to communicate. They're going to be open and honest with you, Scorpio, because I feel like this is time. It's just time. I feel like when you meet this person, Scorpio, it's because it's time. When this person meets you, Scorpio, it's only because it is time here. So this is the romance of getting to know each other as you reveal your most innermost selves to each other. Your bond deepens here. So the more you talk, the more you guys are going to fall for each other. So when we clarify this romance card with the love oracle deck, we have Cupid's arrow here. It says, have fun. Look, I'm trying another one with my glasses, y'all. God damn. All right, I was doing so good. Go me. It says, have faith. It says, have faith. Love is coming. Surprise invitation or meeting. Hesitation. That sounds like your ass, Scorpio. You're going to be hesitant. Because I feel like it's just something that's going to get you a surprise, Scorpio. Because it says surprise invitation here. You're not going to see this coming. But this Cupid arrow, you know, we always see little movies or people trying to act like Cupid. But if you believe in myth and folklore, then you may have heard of Cupid. Cupid is this little angel that goes around and shoots you with the arrow of love. This is a spiritual thing. You can't see, you know, angels represent spirituality too. So this is a spiritual connection. It's like I said, the universe is sending you this, Scorpio. They said, damn, let me go on and shoot Scorpio in the ass with some of this romance energy. Because Scorpio hesitant as it is. So let me go on and just let Scorpio know it's okay, you know. So I feel like this person's going to have to build your trust, Scorpio. But I feel like this person is going to give you what you need in the beginning. So you're going to feel comfortable with this person. Therefore, I feel like you'll move further with this person. Now, Scorpio, your next card here, we have past life relationship. You have known each other before. Now, see, Scorpio, now when it says past life relationship, it doesn't always mean that you were in the same lifetime and, you know, you was childhood friends or you dated a couple of years ago. No, this ain't no ex energy, Scorpio. It's a ex soulmate or ex spiritual mate here, because past life represents if you believe in a reincarnation, you know, like they say, you're going to come back in your next lifetime and you're going to receive karma. So if you believe in past lifetimes and new life cycles and repeated life cycles, then this was someone who you already had a life with, Scorpio. So there is a spiritual connection with this person. Now, this ain't nobody from the past trying to come back in. Yet it is. It's just not this. It's not the same person, Scorpio, yet you already have a connection and a contract with this person. You've already known this person before. You know this person. Y'all could have went through the same shit in the past life. Or you could have been the one running shit and treated them bad. Now you receive a karma, Scorpio. I'm just saying. Who knows? You know, that's how things work. Or this person could have done you bad in the past and this is their lifetime to get it right. So it's like you're coming back in contact, because this is not by chance. You see Cupid's arrow. This is from the gods to send this, because it's something that you get another chance at this. Because if it's a past life, that means you're doing it over. Don't it, Scorpio? Don't start with me, Scorpio. Now, when we clarify this past life relationship, Scorpio, we get ascending. It says transcending obstacles, learning, expansion, new phase, preparing for union. So see, you guys have been preparing for each other. This could have been over and over again, lifetime after lifetime, past life connection here. And each time you get closer and closer and closer to fulfilling your contract, but you just don't ever get there because you're constantly having to do it over. You know you're doing it over this past life. This past life has come back, Scorpio, but it's not a past ex, what I'm saying. This is a spiritual, someone who you knew in another lifetime. So your next card here, Scorpio, we have engagement. It says your love life is ascending to a higher level of commitment. This is with this past life person, and this person ain't never got to put a ring on a Scorpio, but when you guys meet, that's what they mean. Because, you know, look at how all the billions of people in this world here. What are the odds that you're going to meet your person here? You know, so it's like your love life is ascending to a higher level of community. Y'all had to get to each other. y'all had to get to each other, but it's still a process here. It's a process getting to each other, but ultimately, I feel like you guys were already engaged here. I feel like this is a past life commitment that you guys already had in the past, Scorpio. But I feel like this connection is going to be so such in a beautiful, emotional, fulfilling, so much. I feel the same energy in the both of you that it's going to be like you guys known each other for forever. You're going to feel so comfortable. Look how comfortable she feels with this person. You know, y'all going to have that type of connection where before you even say that you're going to settle down and commit, you're going to already start acting like a type of shit. You're just going to fall right into place. And so when we clarify this, we have, I like you. I like you. Someone likes you, Scorpio. Your romance is blooming. Fun, flirting, want to date. So whenever you meet this person going to come out of nowhere. They're going to want to date you here. But the universe is telling you, look, girl, boy, you better date. Don't be sitting here waiting on nobody from this life. We dealing with the past spiritual lives, not the one this time, but another life cycle. Because even our exes, we had that thing done, and you could very well repeat that too. But it's up to you whether or not you repeat that or not. But this person has always liked you in the past life, in this life, in every other life, Scorpio. They've just been looking for you here, Scorpio. But they found you, and because it's time, Cupid's arrow is making this is seen. Cupid's arrow had to show up for Scorpio. And it's almost lover's time, Scorpio. Cupid has a surprise for you because the universe knows what Scorpio going to do and what Scorpio ain't going to do. So the universe going to have to step in and going to have to actually shoot you in the ass, they say, Scorpio. So your last card here, we have passion. Allow your heart and soul to sing with joy, Scorpio. This person is going to move your heart in ways you never even imagined. It's going to make you forget about all of the past disappointments and rejection and bullshit ass relationships. I'm telling you, this person is going to put something on your mind. They're going to make you want to laugh. They're going to make you feel uplifted. They're going to support you, Scorpio. They're going to be there for you, Scorpio. And when we clarify this, we have healthy choices, making healthy choices in love and in life, self-love, self-care, being happier. You're going to be so happy. Scorpio, you're going to be glowing all over the place. You're going to be going to work and they're going to be like, oh, Scorpio must have got some. Oh, Scorpio done got laid. What the fuck? Scorpio done got laid? Say it ain't so. Now, Scorpio, honey, you're going to be, everybody's going to know the change in you, Scorpio. Because when you're sad, your energy shows sadness here. But when you're happy, your energy is vibrant and you're going to be glowing, Scorpio. You made healthier choices because I feel like this person is not going to get you easy, but they're going to win you over so fast because you're going to see so many of the qualities you desire. They're going to get you, honey. But it's destined. This is for you. And at the bottom of this love oracle card, we have heart with a key. Welcoming love, meeting the one, open your heart, getting together. Perfect. It's going to be perfect for you, Scorpio. This is going to be perfect for you, Scorpio. And look, underneath this romance angel oracle deck, this specifically for you, Scorpio, it says, let go of control issues. Allow this situation to unfold naturally. Don't beat it up, Scorpio. Remember that card when it always say your soulmate may differ from your usual type? I always think about that when I meet people. I don't count anyone out, although I may be sad out eyeing them. I still think about those things. You have to let go of control issues. It's time for you to claim your happiness, Scorpio. You deserve it after all. Because underneath this, we have true love. See, Scorpio? All right, Scorpio. This has been your new romance alert, Scorpio. So if you can receive this reading, Scorpio, and this video resonates with you, my darlings, please like, share, subscribe, leave me a comment, hit the notification bell, and I'll talk to you on the next video. Bye, Scorpio.